السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله الحمد لله بنعمته تتم الصالحات. Thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى by His blessing. Right now we are in 26 of Ramadan. Allah. It means tonight Maghrib time will be 27. That's the night we have to looking for. Because there are many strong hadiths. The Laylatul Qadr mostly happen on 27, right? Like when Umar bin Khattab encouraged people to increase their ibadah, their good deed, on the last time of Ramadan, Ibn Abbas said, I know when. You know? Yeah, when? On 27th of Ramadan. Right? What the proof? Look, there is seven heaven, seven earth, you know, 7 days a week, and tawaf 7 times, right? Jamarat 7 times, and many in our ibadat, our good deed, refer to seven, right? And also, he said that it happened during Rasul time, mostly on 27. That's Abdullah bin Abbas, right? And also, if you read the surah about Al-Qadr, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr until hatta matul fajr. This contain 30 huruf. Sorry, 30 words. 30 words. And the word salamun hiya, peace, hiya, it. It refer to laylah, laylatul qadr. Right? That's the word number 27. Subhanallah, exactly. Yeah? And also the word Al-Qadr. Right? Inna anzalnu fi laylatil qadr. That's one. Wa ma adroka ma laylatul qadr. That two. Laylatul qadri. Three. Laylatul qadr, if you count the huruf in that word, right, in that sentence, is contain 9. 9 times 3, 29. Right? And also the surah contain 114 letters. So that's 100 surah of Quran. Right? So there's a lot of significance. So therefore why always everywhere in the world, Masjid was always full. Yeah. So the question now, what, you know, are we prepared? What do we have to do on that night? Because it's a very important night. Allah dedicated a surah, all talk about that. You know, many surah have name, but then talk about that subject, not all. Al-Baqarah, you know, the entire surah not talk about the cow. Right? But this surah, just one surah, is all talk about the Al-Qadr to show how important it might. So the first, of course, Qiyamul Layl. To do Qiyam. That's the most important. I mean, pray. That's what Rasulullah did. That's what the Sahaba did. And also the Hadith said, Man qawma laylatul qadr. You can pray alone. You can pray in masjid, but it's better pray in masjid. Number one is the masjid atmosphere is different. And also, you know, if you're lazy, you're sleepy, there's a lot of people there. They give you boost, give you encourage. Right? Also, we have dua qunut. The imam can qunut, says ameen, ameen. This is very important. Right? So qiyam. It means don't miss isha, tarawih, witir. Then sometimes they have continue with the qiyamul layl. Number two, Al-Quran, re-Quran waqt, right? Increase your recitation of Quran. Yeah? Of course, don't forget dua. Allahumma innaka afoon, tuhibbun afa fa'afana. Put your tongue in heart. Allah, you are the forgiver, please forgive us. Dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please make us among those who set free from hellfire. You know, and also my parents. My brothers, my sister, right? mention all of them. And also make a lot of dhikr. Especially, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك والحمد يوم على كل شيء قدير. Right? That's, you know, the tip what we have to do. But at the same time, don't forget. Remember that. Salamun here, your mind, your heart had to be in peace. And also, you have to be in peace with your parent, your sibling, and everybody. Right? If you can, do itikaf all night, that's the best. Hatta matla il fajr. Don't leave until finish fajr. Right? So, yes, Allah SWT, Allah SWT accept our siyam, our qiyam, our zakat, our ibadat. Yeah. And make us among who will be the winner of Lailatul Qadr.